Hello there, very good afternoon. You're watching Proactive London and joining us today from the Benchmark Holdings team, it's Trond Williksen, accompanied today, as always, by Septima Maguire. Hello to you both.
Hi there.
So today we're talking about the fact that you have released your half year results that you have described as excellent. And these include a 33% jump in revenue and a 100% rise in earnings, your adjusted EBITDA. So we'll go through all of that and much, much more. But let's maybe kickstart the conversation with Trond today, because you've shown some very encouraging results there, if I've just demonstrated. Can you maybe just give us some highlights and tell us what are the drivers behind this performance, if you would?
Yeah, first of all, I just want to restate that we are very happy with the first half of this financial year. You know, you mentioned 33% growth in top line, more than 100% or more than doubling of the adjusted EBITDA. It really shows that we have had very good progress in all the three business areas within the group. We've shown good progress in genetics. We've shown very good progress in advanced nutrition, and we're also progressing our health division. All three business areas have shown double-digit growth, both on top line and on adjusted EBITDA. So we are really happy with that. It's really a continuation of something that you've seen over time since we did the restructuring in 2020. We consistently have lifted our performance, not only on the top line, everybody could grow on the top line, but also on the earnings. And we, if you look at our LTM numbers, they've been ticking consistently up in all the quarters since then. So it really shows the benefit of the restructuring that we have gone through, and it shows the benefit of the commercial attitude, the commercial groundwork that we have done in order to drive results to the group.
Okay, and let's maybe talk about this listing in Oslo. Maybe give us some background on your decision to pursue this.
This has been a consideration that we have done since we announced that in November last year. You know, our job is to make sure that we have as broad an investor base as possible, that we attract as many investors as possible to the group. And if you look at Oslo, you know, it is a listing venue that has built up a significant aquaculture ecosystem around it. You know, it attracts not only investors from Norway, not only investors from the Nordic countries, it really attracts a lot of investors from around the world that is interested in the sector that we are invested in. So why have we been looking at it? Because we want to, we think it's beneficial for us to be part of that ecosystem, both to attract more new investors and get more light on the unique story that Benchmark really is.
All right, exciting. Well, keep us up to date on that one. Let's go over to Septima now, because we're just going to concentrate on the numbers solely now, because you're setting medium-term targets that show growth and profitability. Can you maybe provide some more colour on those and your financial framework as well?
So we've been on a journey in Benchmark with restructuring the business to focus on the core mature aquaculture assets in nutrition and genetics, and then also moving our growth initiatives towards commercialization. So now, having done that, and after posting good revenue and adjusted EBITDA growth last year and in the first half of this year, we're now moving to the phase where we look towards the medium term, the next 3 to 5 years, which then allows us to take what we've built on in terms of the growth and aim for this to continue. So our aim is for the revenue growth to continue in the medium term from 15 to 18% annually. And then this, coupled with adjusted EBITDA margin objectives of 25 to 30%, will allow us to move the cash conversion. So how much money do we get from the profit we make, from 30%, which it was last year, upwards, to make this growth and translate this growth into cash returns, and ultimately to drive free cash flow and returns for the business, crystallizing what we see as the embedded value in the business. In terms of, you know, the infrastructure that we have around this, we've got good cash control, good cost control. We've got very forward-leaning commercial businesses. So we have a lot of the infrastructure ready. And of course, we've got disciplined investment and of course, you know, very clear strategic objectives for the business. So I feel we're well placed to deliver that growth for the business for the future.
All right. Well placed to deliver growth for the future. Thank you very much indeed from Benchmark Holdings there. That's Trond Williksen, the CEO, accompanied today by Septima Maguire, the CFO of the company. Thank you for your time.
Thank you, Kate.